Some time ago, I was looking through the Ireland's Own, and in Jim McCauley's column, I came upon a letter from a lady in County Cavan who really laid into set dancing adjudicators and attacked them for their attitude to set dances from, you know, from different localities than their own, and accused them of all sorts of things. She decried the promotion of mongrel sets under the pretense of being traditional and wondered why adjudicators condone this if they really know what tradition is. Well now, and this brings us on to the half set. Well now, what is a half set? Well, I didn't know this myself until I was up near Bailieborough recently, and this that you're going to see now is a half set. We'll talk about the whole thing afterwards. Well, that was really nice, I must say. I enjoyed it thoroughly. And now I'm going to talk to a man, Packie Sexton, who learned these steps from his father, who learned them from his father. And that's going a fair long distance back. Now, Pete, would you explain to me something about this controversy, about the half set and the attitude of adjudicators? I don't understand it.
Well, the set at one time was very high in this county here.
Yes.
Like you could get 20 sets in any competition.
Yes.
And for instance, the year, I think there was only one set took part in cotillions. Like I think the judges and the experts started to write books on it and put so many marks for this and so many marks for that and very little marks for the actual dance.
Mm.
So I don't know whether they made a good job of it or not.
Well, are you saying that the sort of the central body has turned the thing into a ritual rather than allow people to express their enjoyment and personal joie de vivre in doing these extemporary steps?
That's right. At the moment, if you were fit to march out on the stage and march round, and had nice uniform or costumes, you could win 80% of the competitions.
On appearance alone?
On appearance alone.
Mm.
There's 25 marks for this, 25 marks for that. For footwork and timing and tradition, there's only about 40 marks for all of that.
Yes.
And in my opinion, that is the set.
Right. Now, this is what you're doing now is the Breffni Half Set, is that
the Breffni Half Set.
That means it's exclusive to this county alone?
Well, very near. There is, I think, a few sets dancing it all right, but that whole step now has gone back a long way.
Right.
Because my father was 85, God be good to him, when he died, and he got it from a man of 80 years of age too.
Mm.
Most of them steps.
Could you give us a bit of an example of the sort of, you know,
sort of... I don't know. I'll try it anyway.
Give it a bit of a swing there.
Little
Lovely.
Some of them was dance.
Yes.
All of them was dance 100 years ago.
Yes.
Round nearly every house. There was always an awful interest in dancing around this part.
Well, are you saying to me that in fact, for some reason or other, adjudicators have some sort of a hostility towards what you're doing?
Well, they have, really, they have.
Well, why do you think that is?
Well, I don't know now. Like, for instance, long ago, the old people, like the wore clogs, you see. And the women wore boots. Any woman that was lucky enough to have a pair of boots, there was two row of studs round on them.
Yes.
And it wasn't for dancing, but it was to make sure that they'd last maybe 10 years or so.
Of course.
And them was the boots she danced with. Well, now, if one of the girls has a stud at all in her shoe, you lose a competition over it. There's no such a thing that you're put down on it if there's a stud at all. And it's a pity, you know, if a girl puts in a long time learning steps and timing and everything like that, that she has to wear a rubber pair of shoes to cover that up.
Mm.
Like, that's my opinion, you know. Because there is a lot of timing, and you're not supposed to wear studs in your shoes. That's some of the rules.
Well, like, can you tell me why?
Here in Cavan alone at score, one said they brought it up with the adjudicator, what was wrong with us there? And he says, well, you better go to Dublin, whoever wrote this book, and have it out with them. Say nothing to me.
What message would you send to these adjudicators now?
I think if they give more marks on footwork and timing and tradition, that'd sum up a lot of it.
And let the dancers wear studs if they want to.
Well, if they have good footwork and a good set to suit it, a good set to suit it, they should be let hit it out.